organic learning.
That's right, you guys. We got some emergency vehicles to cover today. We got a whole bunch, and these are really important. So let's jump right in and let's do it. Okay, you guys, first one of the day, and I absolutely love it. This, you guys, is a police motorcycle. Yeah, check that out. Woo, woo. There's gonna be a lot of that today, gang. Now, these can be really, really great because if it's crowded or there's a lot of traffic or something like that, the police motorcycles, because they're narrow, can actually squeeze between the cars and the trucks and get to the scene first. So they can make sure that everybody's okay and that, you know, they can keep traffic moving and that sort of thing. Now, this one is made by Honda, and as you can see right there, it says Honda Police. And let me tell you, it is outfitted with some really cool features. You got all these cool lights and sirens all the way around. You got a super bright, wide headlight on the front there. Very, very bright invisible brake light so everyone can see this motorcycle coming through. You got a couple of like saddlebags here on the back for supplies and everything that the police officer would need. And of course, you've got a really powerful engine. Brum, 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 brum. No, whoa, hold on, hold on. I guess they'll only pop a wheelie if they absolutely have to. I love this one, and this, you guys, is a police motorcycle. Okay, you guys, next up, I'm pretty sure everybody knows what this is. This, you got it, is a police car. Yeah, really cool. This is a black and white, and actually that's what they sometimes call police cars, black and whites. Got your basic lights here on the top, and what's really cool, though, is you got this giant push bumper on the front. Now, these push bumpers are very useful if the police car is ever in a chase after a bad guy. Let's say the silver car is the bad guy and they're driving all over town. What he'll do is he'll actually come into the side here and spit him out. Then the silver car will stall, and that way the officers can get out and be like, hey, put your hands up. That's really, really important. That's called the pit maneuver. Now, this particular police car is a Dodge Charger, and you know that that is just built for power. Now, one other feature which is really interesting is there's kind of like a little metal fence which separates the front seats from the back seats. That way, if there's any bad guys in the back, they can't touch or mess with the officers in the front. This is really cool, you guys, and this, of course, is a police car. All right, now I bet you guys have also seen this one before. This, of course, you got it, everybody, is an ambulance. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. All right, now ambulances are really important. Now, when people are hurt or injured, an ambulance will be there to help. Now, sometimes paramedics can actually treat people right there on the scene, but sometimes if someone is really, really injured, they need to put them on a stretcher and then load them in the back of the ambulance. As you can see right there, there's a kind of like a long bed for the patient to actually lay down on. Then the paramedics can help treat them, and then somebody up front drives this thing really, really fast. Runs all the red lights because we gotta make sure you get that person to the hospital right away so that they are okay. Yep, if you ever see these ambulances coming through, you better pull over. This, you guys, is an ambulance. Alright, gang, I've got two words to describe this next one. Super awesome! This, you guys, is a SWAT truck. Yeah, check this out, SWAT truck. You are pretty cool. Now, if there's ever a really, really bad, really dangerous situation, people will call in the SWAT truck. Now, inside the SWAT truck are highly trained officers to deal with, like I said, a really, really dangerous situation. Now, this vehicle that they'll arrive in is really, really cool, and it is outfitted with a lot of awesome features. Now, you've got these really, really big tires, which are run flats, so these things can go over glass and nails, metal and debris, and never get flat. They are super tough. You've got a push bumper on the front, just like the police cruiser, but this one is so strong, I mean, you could push over a big old SUV, even a truck or something like that. Bulletproof glass all the way around. Got this armor plating in the back and the sides, even the front. Big row of lights to let them know you're coming through, and there's a hatch big enough for one of the officers to pop up, look around, and see what's going on. Whoa! This SWAT truck is something, you guys. Check it out. This is a SWAT truck. All right, you guys. Yeah! I think we all know what this bad boy is. This is a fire engine. Wee-hoo, wee-hoo. Make way, make way. Fire engine number 81 is coming through. Now, what's really interesting about this one is this fire engine actually carries about 1,000 gallons of water right on board. So, if there's a fire in a remote location, don't have to worry about finding a fire hydrant or anything like that. It's all ready to go. Now, this shiny part in the middle is called the pump panel. You can see these knobs and levers and switches. This is where the whole fire truck is actually controlled. Now, they'll go ahead and hook up the hoses here on the sides and go ahead and put that fire O-U-T out. Very cool stuff. This is a fire engine. All right, you guys, check out this one. Now, this one is pretty awesome. This is a ladder truck. Yeah! Now, do you know why it's called a ladder truck? Because there's a ladder right on the top. Now, check this out. This ladder is so interesting because it can just keep expanding really, really far. This is great if there's a fire in a tall building, and you need to get up there and actually save some people, and of course, reach a fire, which may be really, really high. This is called a turntable ladder, and as you can see, whoa, as I swing it way over, I mean, this thing gives the firefighters a lot of access. Now, unlike the fire engine, this ladder truck doesn't have its own water supply, so it does need to hook up to a hydrant or some source of water supply to help put those fires out. But really, really useful and really fun to see in action, you guys. This is a ladder truck. Okay, gang, check out this next one. Wow, this is so cool. This is a Fire Chief SUV. Wow, I mean, this one is crazy. I really, really like the styling of this one. Now, when there's a bigger fire or event, the fire chief will show up in his own or her own SUV. Now, the fire chief will actually kind of do the coordinating of all the efforts to make sure the fire or whatever is happening goes as smoothly and efficiently as possible. And as you can see, they've got a really cool yellow, bright coloring to it, so you know the fire chief is rolling in. Now, on the side here, we're gonna get real close. You got the cool symbol on the side, fire chief. You got the American flag. I mean, all kinds of, you know, extra lights and sirens on the side, reflective material here, and I love these cool black mag wheels. And remember, if there's ever an emergency, what do we dial? 911, you got it. This, you guys, is a Fire Chief SUV. All right, everybody, this next one is a very interesting one, and I'm not sure if everyone has seen one of these, so let me talk about it right now. This is a Hazmat truck. Yeah, you see that? Hazmat team. Now, Hazmat is an abbreviation for hazardous materials. So, like the SWAT team is kind of a special group of the police force, the Hazmat team is a special group of the fire department. So let me give you an example so you can understand how this works. Let's say there's a big oil tanker driving down the freeway and uh-oh, he spills oil everywhere. That is not good. They will call in the Hazmat team, and the Hazmat team has all the right tools and equipment to properly and effectively clean up all that oil, because that oil, of course, is toxic and dangerous and slippery, and you can't have people driving over it. So they'll come in, and as you can see here, there's doors and shelves all over this thing, specialized equipment to clean up certain spills like that. They'll come in, they'll clean it up, and they'll open up that freeway right away so traffic can start going right through again. This is very cool, you guys, and this, of course, is a Hazmat truck. Wow! Look at this next one! Hello! This is huge, you guys! This is a mobile command vehicle. My goodness, this one is enormous. Now, kind of like the fire chief, when something really, really big is happening, the mobile command vehicle is called onto the scene. Now, this is absolutely loaded with features, and it has the ability to issue warnings and statements to local news channels to make sure that everyone knows what's going on and make sure that no one is going to be in danger. Now, it can do that via these really high-powered antennas and satellites here on the back. And as you can see, the sides actually expand to create more room inside the mobile command vehicle. Of course, this thing is huge. It's about 40 feet long. It's got a giant, shiny bumper on front. Tons of lights and sirens. I mean, it takes a couple people to drive one of these. Here's the doorway where people can enter. Again, you've got a side compartment here which expands, and you've even got a porthole on the top so someone can look outside and see exactly what's going on. These are quite a sight, you guys, and this is a mobile command vehicle. Woo! Okay, team, last one of the day, and check this out. It is the only one of the day that actually flies. So cool. This is a rescue helicopter. Wow, I think this one is just so, so cool, you guys. Now, let's say someone is hiking, or maybe they're out on their boat on the ocean, and they become stranded. This rescue helicopter will save the day. It flies in, opens up this side door, and actually releases a rope where the person can hook up to the rope, and then it brings them all the way back in here. They get in the cabin of the helicopter, close the door, and this helicopter will fly them to safety. Now, if they happen to be injured, it will take them straight to the hospital and actually just land right there on the roof. It's got a really cool rotor right there on top, and of course, with any helicopter, that's what gives it all its lift. These things are very, very cutting edge, and of course, they're used by the military and the Coast Guard all over the world. This, you guys, is a rescue helicopter. Yeah! All right, everybody! I had a really good time going over these emergency vehicles with you. We had some awesome ones today. These are so important, you guys. I hope you had fun. I know I did. Double thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Organic learning.
Welcome back, everybody. Today we have more incredible emergency vehicles. These are so important. Let's learn all about them right now. Let's do it. All right, you guys, our first emergency vehicle of the day, and it is a beauty. This, of course, is a tow truck. Yeah, check this one out. Man, I like this cool silver tow truck. Now, tow trucks are really important and very, very helpful because if you ever are stranded in your car or truck on the side of the road, these tow trucks here, they will come to the rescue, man. These are great. As you can see, it's got a really strong mechanical arm here off the back. Now, let's just say this is your car over here. Oh, my car won't start. It won't work. Oh, don't worry, I'll help you. So the tow truck will just back right up, go underneath, and kind of lift it up. So that way, it can drive it right to the repair shop, broom, and get it all fixed. I mean, these things are wonderful. Now, tow truck drivers, some of them at least, are actually mechanics too. And they can do some basic tinkering with your car and maybe get it going. As you can see here on the side, they got a couple doors where they keep lots of tools. So they may be able to get it going without actually having to give it a tow. They got some big old bumpers, big old tires here, and oh, lots of lights and sirens, so you know they are coming through. This, you guys, is very cool, and of course, this is a tow truck. All right, you guys, this next one is a little bit sneaky, and you'll see what I mean in just a second, but this is a fire engine. Now, the thing about this is it's not an ordinary fire engine. This is called a Unimog. That's right, it's a funny name. Unimog, and it's made by Mercedes-Benz. You can see their logo right on the front there. Now, this thing is really cool because it's made specifically for wildfires. As you can see, it's a little bit more narrow than your normal fire truck, but what gets really interesting is that it's got independent axles and shocks, which basically go in every direction, and all the tires are able to be inflated or deflated depending on what kind of terrain it's driving on. So this thing can go through streams and small rivers, over big rocks, up really steep mountainsides, down really steep hills, wherever it needs to go, the Unimog can do it. It is full-time, four-wheel drive, and it carries up to 800 gallons of water. Now, another cool feature is that it's got this sunroof here on top where an operator can actually pop his or her head out and spray a hose all over the wildfire. So as this thing's fighting its way to the heart of the fire, it can already start putting it out. This is pretty wild. This is a Unimog, and this is a fire engine. Wow, check out this next one. Now this is completely over the top, you guys. This is a ventilation fire truck. Have you ever seen one of these before? I'll be honest, I had never seen one of these either until I started doing a little research on it. Now, most fire trucks, what do? They spray water over the fire. This one's very interesting. Instead of spraying water, it's got this giant fan on the back, and it actually blows air right out the fan. Now, what it does is sometimes you'll have a structure, whether it's a house or an office building, and it's filled with smoke. Well, that's not good. There could be soot in there as well. It'll back right up to the structure, maybe one of the openings, whether it's a door or a window. Turn on this fan and it'll blow all that smoke and soot right on out. That way you can clear the building and make sure it's super safe and all the fire and smoke is contained. Now, if this truck can't get close enough, they can actually hook up a tubing system, and the tube can go right into the front door or a side door, and they can do the exact same procedure that way. This is absolutely wild, you guys, and this is a ventilation fire truck. Whoa! Check out this one, you guys. Awesome! This is a rescue crane. Whoa! I want you to see this from every angle, you guys. This one is really cool. Now, this rescue crane is kind of like having a super strong arm out there. Let's say a big rig, is on its side. Well, the rescue crane can come over to it. It's got this big strong arm that I talked about. Wow, check that out. It rotates 360. What it can do, it can extend itself right here, actually pick up the big rig, put it on its tires, and then a tow truck can come in and tow it away to get repaired. But check this out, it's got full 360 capabilities. I mean, this thing is awesome, you guys. Super strong and able to do so many tasks for any type of emergency situation. It's got six huge tires on the bottom because this thing has to go just about anywhere. And this crane has to pick up just about anything. As you can see, the crane operator actually sits right here in the back. Then you got a couple of drivers right up front, you guys. This is awesome. This is a rescue crane. Woo! Check out this next one, gang. This one is pretty wild. This is called an auxiliary power truck. That's right. Let me give you a quick 360 of this one. This one is really cool. Now, the way this one works is, let's say there's an accident on the side of the freeway or the road. The auxiliary power truck will come right up, and what it has is a bunch of generators built into the side. Then on top here, it's got a couple of very powerful floodlights that, as you can see, flip up in a really cool way and actually rotate 360. That'll light up the whole area wherever the accident's located. That way, everyone can see what's going on. All the traffic can see what's going on. They can slow down. As you can see on the side here, it says, give us a break. That's because whenever you see an emergency vehicle, you gotta slow it down, people, okay? Let them do their jobs. It's got number 57 on the side there. That's really cool. And if any other emergency vehicles may need some power, this auxiliary power truck has it. They can plug right in and get the power that they need. This, you guys, is an auxiliary power truck. Whoa! All right, you guys, admit it. You've been eyeing this one all day. Well, you know what? So have I. This is a rescue boat. And check it out. Bam! This is FDNY. That's New York City Fire Department. That is very cool. Now, these rescue boats will patrol the harbor, the Hudson, the East River, to make sure everything and everybody are doing okay. Now, some of the cool features, as you can see, it's got a center console here. The driver actually sits in the middle. There's the steering wheel. It's got a big old roll bar right here, and it's got a light right on top. Giant single outboard engine for a lot of power, and what's really neat is it's actually kind of a raft on top that's inflatable, and the bottom is steel, so that way it can drive over something and it won't damage the boat. Now, it also has this low clearance around the whole perimeter of the boat. That way, the firefighters can actually jump out real quick, save somebody, and pull them right back in. This thing is very cool, you guys, and this is a rescue boat. Whoa, wait a minute. Did somebody just say Baywatch alert? This, you guys, is a lifeguard truck. Yeah, check that out. See, I was telling the truth, it says lifeguard right on the side. Now, this particular one is San Diego Fire and Rescue, and it looks like Toyota makes this lifeguard truck. Now, if you've ever been to the beach, you have seen these trucks. These things patrol the beaches and make sure that everybody's safe. They have the ability to go into the water just a little bit and, of course, go over the sand, even hit some gnarly sand dunes if need be. Now, if anyone's in trouble, they've got these cool surfboards on top. The lifeguards will hop right out of the truck, they'll grab the surfboard, and they'll go into the water and rescue whoever needs rescuing. They've got other supplies here in the back, of course, and you gotta love the really cool kind of white racing stripe and red coloring. You guys, that is very sharp. This, of course, is a lifeguard truck. All right, gang, this next one, this one has a little twist, so pay close attention, you guys. This is an ambulance. Ah, okay, looks pretty normal, but wait a minute. This is actually an ambulance just for kids. Check it out. Now, this one is actually very popular in Germany. As you can see here, it's got a word in German. I'm gonna try and say it. Nobody laugh. Kindernotarzt. Now, in German, that actually means children emergency doctor. Okay? Now, check it out. It's got bright, beautiful colors. And right here in the window, it's even got a bumblebee holding a little first aid kit. Now, it's got some colorful blue lights there, more writing on the front. As you can see, this one's made by Volkswagen. And what's really interesting is that, you know, treating an adult is different from treating a kid. So this one really gears towards the treatment of children, and we just think that's really cool and really special, you guys. This is very fun. You know what I heard? It even has colorful sheets on the inside. And they give you a lollipop. That's pretty awesome, you guys. This is an ambulance. Woo! Yeah! Check out this one, you guys. Totally, totally awesome. This, of course, is a police helicopter. Oh man, check out the rotor on top. Wow, that thing really moves. Of course, that rotor gives it all its lift. That's what is so neat about helicopters. Now, this police helicopter is so beneficial because it helps officers who are actually on the ground. Maybe they're looking for a bad guy, maybe there's a high-speed chase going on, something like that. These helicopters just fly up in the air, and of course they can go faster than any car could, and they can help all those officers and tell them where to look. Now, if it's night, a lot of these copters have what's called a million candle power night sun, or basically a giant spotlight. They turn that on and they will turn night into day. It is pretty awesome if you've ever seen one of these in action, you guys. Check that out. I love the graphics. Wow. Number 68 here on the side, that is good stuff. And one more of these, oh yeah, that's awesome, you guys. This is a police helicopter. Whoa, it's our last last one of the day, you guys, and check this out. Hello! This, yeah, is a water drop plane. Now, some people call this a tanker plane, and it's used for fighting wildfires. Now, it stores water in the middle or the belly of the plane and then drops it over the fire to put them out. This particular one is really neat. It's got pontoons on the side here. That allows the plane to actually skim the surface of a body of water, pick it up, fill up the belly, and then drop that water right over the fire. Now, other types of planes will actually land, fill up with water manually. They'll mix it with some chemicals to really help put the fire out even faster. As you can see, these things are massive. That's why it has four big propellers here to power the plane, and this one's capable of holding 1,600 gallons, but the biggest ones, they can hold over 20,000 gallons of water. Whoa, that is a lot of water. Check this out, you guys. Very cool stuff, and this is a water drop plane. Woo, man, we had a great time today going over all of these amazing emergency vehicles. I had a blast. Can't wait, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Organic learning.
Woo! You guys, check this out. We have got another wonderful, awesome, over-the-top day planned. Some emergency vehicles. These are so important. Let's jump right in. Let's do it. All right, you guys, first emergency vehicle of the day. Check this one out. This is a police truck. Oh, yeah. Wow, check this one out. Woo, it's doing a spinorama. This, of course, check out the front, is a Chevrolet, and this particular one is a Silverado. That's right, this is a pickup truck. As you can see, you got the bed here in the back, and this particular one is an extended cab or a dual cab. So, it has lots of room for officers. On the front here, it's got a big old push bumper. Somebody breaks down, it can push them over to the side of the road so they're safely off the road. Big old wheels, check that out. I mean, this thing is full-time, four-wheel drive, so we can go just about anywhere. Up something steep, whoa! Or down something real steep, whoa! Man, this thing is very, very versatile. And this, of course, is a police truck. All right, check out this next one, you guys. Boom, right there. This, you guys, is a police Jeep. That's right, wow, I want one of these. Now, of course, these are really, really common in beach communities. So maybe you live by the ocean or, you know, a big lake, something like that. You will see these police Jeeps. Now, what's so great about them is they're really, really versatile. Of course, you got four-wheel drive, you got some big old tires. Gives the ability of the officers to drive on the road, on trails, and also, of course, all over the sand. They can even get into the water a little bit, as long as they don't go too deep with that. Salt water and most vehicles do not agree. But these things are incredible. You got a hard top that can actually come off. You got a big thing of sirens here. And in the summertime, like I said, you can take off this hard top and maybe just get some sun for the officers. They look pretty cool driving this around the beach communities. This particular one, oh yeah, check it out. Hermosa Beach, that's in Southern California. If you've never been there, you want to check out Hermosa. That is the place to be, you guys. This is a police Jeep. Check out this next one, you guys. Whoa! This is so cool. This is like from the future or something. This is a wildfire truck. Yeah! Now this thing is good, and let me take that back. Great at doing one thing, putting out wildfires. It's all-wheel drive, and it's kind of like a tank on wheels that puts out fires. Everybody gets inside there, and they're fully protected. And this allows you to get really close to the wildfire, but still be safe. So there's operators on the inside. They use cameras and giant screens to see where the flames are. And then they use a controller, kind of like you would on a PlayStation or Xbox, that controls the nozzle that shoots the water on the fire, and boom, that wildfire is out. Now, these are actually built in Japan, so you'll see them all over Japan, and as you can see, they got lots of features. Two ladders on the back. It holds a lot of water, so you don't need to hook up to a hydrant. And I mean, just a cutting-edge design, you guys. This is a Wildfire truck. Okay, gang, I'm sure you've seen one of these before. This is pretty standard stuff. What do we got here? This is a police motorcycle. Eh, no big deal, you know, two wheels, police motorcycle. Wait a minute, what? Ah! This one's got a sidecar! That is so cool! Now, if you've never seen a police motorcycle with a sidecar, well, now you have. Now, the driver will actually sit right here and steer the motorcycle, and then the passenger, maybe his or her partner, will sit there, and they can kind of cruise around in tandem and, you know, kind of fight crime. Or maybe you could put a bad guy in there. Yeah, maybe that's a place for the bad guy to go. What else could go in the sidecar? I don't know, maybe it's a canine unit, and you can put the doggy right there with some safety goggles on. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Or what else? I don't know. Maybe put your lunch in the sidecar. I mean, I could go on, you guys. I'm just having a good time. Now, where's this one from? Let's check it out. Ah, Tonka County. You know, that's good stuff in Tonka County if they're driving around in these things with sidecars. That's a lot of fun, you guys. And this is a police motorcycle. Wow! Talk about cutting-edge technology, you guys. This thing is incredible. I can't wait to tell you about it. This is an ARF truck. That's right, it's got kind of a funny name. Now, ARF actually stands for Airport Rescue and Firefighting. Now, this particular model is a Colette K30E Jaguar, and you can kind of see that on the side there. Now, you will find these at airports, and one of their biggest assets is that these things are very, very fast. I mean, they're fast, and they're really maneuverable. All right? When there's an airport fire, this Colette has to get there super quick. So, it's got all-wheel drive. It's got a really aggressive 6x6 wheel design, as you can see here. And as soon as it gets there, it uses this really high hose, and it puts out the fire. It's also got this wraparound glass, making it very good and easy for the person driving it to see what's going on, okay? There's a lot of action at an airport, and you want to make sure when you're hurrying to a fire, you don't hit anything on the way. They hold a lot of water, specifically 3,000 gallons, and if you wanted to buy one, you better save up about $1 million, because that's how much these things cost. This is so cool, and this is an ARF truck. All right, you guys, wow, check this thing out. This is a super ambulance. That's right. Now, this particular one is from Japan, and sometimes it'll be referred to as a field ambulance. Now, you can see the Japanese characters there on the side. That's really cool. And they'll call it a field ambulance because it'll actually go to the scene of kind of a, you know, a larger accident. So let's say several people were hurt or injured. This super ambulance can come to the scene and kind of set up shop and treat many people at once. It even has sides that expand. So if you look in the back of this, you'd be able to see a very large area where it can treat lots of people at the same time. And that's really, really helpful. It actually comes with a couple of doctors, several nurses. So this thing can set up shop for a while until everybody is feeling better. This is incredible, you guys. And this is a super ambulance. Wow, check out this next one, you guys. Boom! Cool color and even cooler when I tell you what it does. This is a hovercraft. Now, what's really unique about this is it has the ability to go on land and also the water. I mean, that is so cool. Now, when you start it up, this tan tubing that goes all the way around actually fills up with air. That allows it to go on the water, and it's got a real tough bottom here so it can go on any type of terrain. It's got powerful fans in the back which actually power it in any direction you want to go. Now, this is so cool. This is why the Coast Guard and the military use this, because it's a very diverse piece of equipment. It can go from the street to the beach and right into the ocean and then back again. I mean, that is so cool. And on a personal note, when I was a little boy, I actually had this same hovercraft, and I remember playing with this thing all the time. Had the cool rescue right there on the tail, and the jets, and all the cool, like, silver trim. I mean, this was a lot of fun, you guys. This is a hovercraft. Alright, everybody, check out this next one. This is a really cool one. I know what you're saying. Hey, that's not an emergency vehicle. Well, it is. This, you guys, is an unmarked police car. Check this out. Now, most of the time, the siren actually is not on top, alright? So these are perfect because the detective or whoever's undercover can get really close, maybe during a stakeout or something like that, and listen and observe to see what the bad guys are up to. Then, when something goes down, they put this siren and light on top. It's actually magnetized, so they just stick it up there with their hand, and boom, they are in hot pursuit, taking those bad guys down. I mean, that is really cool to see them in action. This is a very, very important part of police work, and this, you guys, is an unmarked police car. All right, you guys, this thing is absolutely fantastic. Check it out. This is a Chevy Blazer 4x4. Yeah, that is some cool, cool stuff. Now, this particular one, I'm gonna go in close, is Rocky Mountain Rescue. Does anybody know what the Rocky Mountain state is? You got it, Colorado. Rado, man, that is some cool stuff in Colorado. And of course, they have such diverse terrain there. You have to get a vehicle that can go everywhere. Well, this 4x4 is four-wheel drive, so it can go up steep hills, down steep hills, I mean, through the water. This thing is even good in the snow. And in Colorado, you got cross-country skiers, backpackers, hikers. Any and everybody is outdoors in Colorado. And this thing, if they're ever in a pinch, will be there to help. Couldn't do it without this one. And this is a Chevy Blazer 4x4. Okay, you guys, last emergency vehicle of the day, and whoa, here it comes. It's a big one. Check this out. Shoop! This is a search and rescue plane. Wow, this thing is enormous. Now, as we know, people can get lost, people can get stuck, and the search and rescue plane is really great at finding them. What it does is it takes to the air, of course, and you get a bird's eye view of a very large area, okay? Now, if the people actually aren't able to get rescued right away, the search and rescue plane can actually open its back door here and attach some supplies to a parachute. That'll fall down, it'll give the people some food, some drinking water, until a ground rescue team can come in and actually take them to safety. Now, this holds a lot of fuel, so it can go really, really far off the coast if it needs to, like maybe look somewhere over the ocean if somebody's stranded at sea. Of course, as you can see here, the Coast Guard uses these all the time. These are so important, and it's got four giant propellers because this thing weighs a lot, you guys. This is really important, and this is a search and rescue plane. Going over all these awesome emergency vehicles, you guys. What a blast! Double thumbs up. Can't wait to see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
If you liked our video, please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and leave a fun comment below. Thanks, everybody.